We're back at the Boston Convention and Exhibition Center. I'm Rhonda Anderson, reporting from the American Diabetes Association's 75th Scientific Sessions, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. Oral medications can help people with type 2 diabetes reach their blood glucose targets. But there has been a cloud of suspicion over new diabetes drugs and whether they may increase the risk for cardiovascular and other problems. Two research studies presented today at the Scientific Sessions explore this very question. This is especially important because heart disease and stroke are the number one causes of death and disability among people with type 2 diabetes. The evaluation of lexisenatide in acute coronary syndrome study, ELIXA for short, is the very first clinical trial to study cardiovascular safety in a GLP-1 receptor agonist, one member of a class of widely prescribed drugs used to lower blood glucose levels in people with type 2 diabetes. These drugs are derived from gut hormones and may be used as a secondary treatment when other medications fail to sufficiently lower blood glucose levels. In the ELIXA study, researchers examined 6,068 people from 49 countries, randomly assigning them to lexisenatide or a placebo, with a follow-up period of more than 2 years. The results? Lexisenatide had a neutral effect on heart failure and other cardiovascular problems. Specifically, the study found no increased risk for cardiovascular death, heart attack, stroke, chest pain, or heart failure in people with type 2 diabetes who had recently experienced heart problems and were therefore at a high risk for more problems. The trial also showed that those who took lexisenatide were not more likely to have problems with low blood glucose than those who took a placebo, despite better blood glucose control. Also, the researchers discovered no increase in pancreatitis or cancers, plus a modest benefit in terms of weight gain. Those taking lexisenatide did not gain weight, while those taking a placebo did. However, the study participants did report higher levels of nausea and vomiting, which are common side effects for GLP-1 receptor agonists. Another study, TECOS, which stands for the Trial Evaluating Cardiovascular Outcomes with Sitagliptin, looked at the impact of adding sitagliptin, a DPP-4 inhibitor, to the diabetes management plan for people with type 2 diabetes and established cardiovascular disease. TECOS followed 14,671 patients for a median of 3 years and found that adding the drug did not affect the patient's risk for major adverse cardiovascular events, hospitalization for heart failure, or other adverse events compared to a placebo. It's also worth noting that the researchers didn't observe significant effects on the pancreas with this therapy, such as acute pancreatitis or pancreatic cancer. With any prescription drug, doctors and patients alike want to be confident that the treatment is worth the benefits, that it doesn't solve one problem only to present another. Thanks to these studies, we can now say that people with type 2 diabetes are safe taking a GLP-1 receptor agonist or sitagliptin to improve their blood glucose levels, even if they are at high risk for heart-related problems. To view this press release online, visit the newsroom section of our website, diabetes.org. The TECOS results will be published online in the New England Journal of Medicine as well. And for the latest coverage of diabetes research and updates from the 75th Scientific Sessions, visit diabetes.org/breakingnews. And on social media, use our hashtag 2015ADA.